Hello everyone, Alex here from warrenoffkeys.com, and in this video I'm going to show you how you can install MongoDB locally on your own machine. So to get started, if you go to Google and you type in MongoDB download, you should see a top link right here. You can ignore the ad, but the top link right here, if we click on that, we'll get sent to a page like this. And if it's not already selected, you want to select on-premise. And you want to select community server. This will be the free server that we can download. On the right, we want to select the latest version and your platform. MSI should be fine, and then click on download. So you should be directed to a screen like this, and your download should start. I'm going to click on keep, and I'll give this a few seconds here. So my download has completed, and I can click right here to run the installer. We get a page like this. I can click on next. I have to agree to the license agreement here, and then click on next. I'm going to select a complete install. So here we see a data directory, and this is the path that is important here. You want to copy this. You can click and do Control A and Control C to copy it. And then we want to click on next. We're going to be using that path later. We do want to install MongoDB Compass. This will make our lives much easier when it comes to actually looking at the data within our database. You can click on next and then click on install. It should be sent to a screen like this. You might have to authorize it for administrator permissions. Okay, so after waiting a few minutes, we get sent to a screen like this. We can simply click on finish. And then here we see Mongo Compass community is opening in the background. For now, we can actually minimize this. We should still have that path copied. Now you're going to want to open up your file explorer. And in the URL bar, you want to paste in that path and press enter. You should be sent to a page like this with all this nonsense here. We don't actually care about any of this. We want to click on the 4.2 and we get sent to right here. We want to navigate into the bin folder, and then we want to copy this path right here. And here we see mongod.exe. If we actually click on this, it'll open up our command line. However, this is the default Windows command line. If you want to open it in a specific terminal, we can actually close this. We then want to navigate to your console or terminal of choice here. Mine is Cmder. A link to this will be in the video description. So within here, we want to actually change our directory to the directory we just copied from our Windows Explorer. We can do that with the cd command for change directory, and then we can paste in the URL. I can click on this, I can go to edit, and then I can click paste, or alternatively in this console, I can just simply right click. Now I can press enter, and we see that we've navigated to this directory. We now want to run mongod.exe by simply typing in the name and pressing enter. Now if I expand this, we see an exception right here. Non-existent path, data directory in C, data DB, not found. So the database didn't actually start up correctly. We actually have to create this path right here. This is a few folders we need to create. And if you do see a different path, then you'll need to create that path on your own machine. However, mine is the C drive, and then the data folder, and then a DB folder. I'm going to move this over to the left. Now, within my Windows Explorer, I can navigate to my C drive. I can make a new folder by right-clicking and going to new folder. I'll call this data. Now we're getting into that. I'm going to make another folder called DB. Now, if I bring my console back over here, I can press up in the console. This is going to run the last command or view the last command that I ran, and I can press enter. And now we see a slightly different screen. There's a lot more text here, and I don't know what most of the stuff says, but if you look for this small line right here, it says listening on 127.0.0.1. This is actually your local machine's IP. And a few lines below that, we see waiting for connections on port 27017. This is the default port for MongoDB. If you see a screen like this with these lines, that means that everything is working correctly and you have successfully installed MongoDB on your machine. However, we want to actually view some information. So if I minimize the console and I open up Mongo Compass, which should have been automatically open for you, we see under new connection at the top left, we have this input field here. To actually connect to your Mongo server, you can type in mongodb :// localhost, which is the exact same thing as 127.0.0.1. They're interchangeable, but I just prefer localhost. And then colon, and this will be your port, which will be 27017. And that's the default port that we saw in our console a few seconds ago. We could then click on connect. And you should see a screen like this. Ignore the Discord bot. That's something from another series. However, if you see a screen with admin, config, and local, that means that everything is set up correctly, and you are now connected to your Mongo server within MongoDB Compass. Thanks for watching this MongoDB tutorial. If you need help or have a video request, feel free to leave a comment down below or ask in the Worn Off Keys Discord, which will be linked in the video description. If you want to learn more about MongoDB, you can consider clicking on one of the videos you see on your screen now.